الحمد لله رب العالمين وكفى والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن سن سنته واهتدى بهديه إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب ما كان حديثا يفترى ولكن تصديق الذي بين يديه وتفصيل كل شيء وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون صدق الله العظيم. My dear and respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah which I recited to you and which is from Surah Yusuf. In fact, this is the last ayah of Surah Yusuf. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, in the stories that I have mentioned in Quran, لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ. Qasas means stories. So in the stories that I have mentioned in Quran, عِبْرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. There is lesson to be learned, but only those people who will learn these lessons, أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ, who are the intelligent people. Ulul Albab means intelligent people. Ma kana hadithan yuftara. And believe that these stories are not fabricated by Rasulullah sallam. Walakin tasdeeq alladhi bayna yadayh. But these stories are reaffirming the books that are already present in the world, meaning Torah and Injil. وَتَفْصِيلَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that in these stories you will find lessons and many, many lessons. وَرَحْمَةً لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ. And in these stories there are sources of mercy, meaning your life will become better if you will learn these lessons and apply them in your life. لِقَوْمِ يُؤْمِنُونَ. But it's only for people who believe. Now my dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have narrated many, many stories in Quran. Right? And before and after, and in the middle as well, of these stories, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have time and again mentioned that there is this lesson to be learned, that lesson to be learned, this lesson. Many a time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have repeated this sentence that there are lessons to be learned from these stories. Now, this point that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى, that these stories are not fabricated. Think why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this. Because people who denied Quran, they were accusing of our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of learning these stories from some people, from Jewish people who have knowledge of Torah, some Christian pastors and priests and monks who have knowledge of Torah and Injil and Zabur. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى. This story is not fabricated. Now, brothers and sisters, which laqab of our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is one of the most shining laqab of our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had mentioned in Quran many times? Our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No, An-Nabiy al-Ummi. You see, this laqab al-ummi, brothers and sisters, al-ummi means unlettered. Unlettered. Somebody who cannot read and write. Now for you, if somebody calls you al-ummi, it is an offensive laqab for you. Somebody tells you that you are an illiterate person. So you will feel offended, right? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَّ الْأُمِّيِّ. That my Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is an unlettered person. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this laqab al-ummi to increase in the prestige of our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the reason for that is, if Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was extremely educated person, right? And then when he would convey Quran to people, people will say, well, you learn it from somewhere. You learn it. Some school, some college, from some rabbis or some pastors. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala time and again is enforcing this belief that our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never met any rabbi, he never met any pastor, he did not go to any school. He is so unlettered sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that if and where his name sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad, Meem, Ha, Meem, Dal, four letters, right? Meem, Ha, Meem, Dal, Muhammad, if his own name is written somewhere, he could not read his own name. Right? So he's so unlettered. Right? And he never met anyone. Right? So now such a person, when he is claiming that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given him this book, and in this book there are stories and stories and stories of nations and people who had come and lived before. Right? So Rasulullah did not knew any of these stories before. None of them. Right? And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not learn about these stories from anywhere. This is the reason why in the next sentence Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالتَّصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. That بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ means the books that you have. Quran is doing tasdeeq, is reaffirming the facts. And wherever you people have changed, right, Torah and Injil, so Quran is putting the record straight. Right? Wherever you have, for example, wherever Jewish people, right, in Torah and Talmud, for example, just one example, wherever they have accused Maryam, the mother of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, of being a wicked woman. They say that no, she was a very unchaste woman. She committed adultery, zina. And Jesus is the illegitimate child of Maryam. She was a very wicked lady, right? That's what they believe. That's what they say. Now, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is defending Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam. And then Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Quran, and then in defense of Maryam, Allah said, وَإِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاكِ. First one, you are chosen by Allah. وَطَهَّرَكِ, and you are a very chaste woman. وَاسْتَفَاكِ عَلَىٰ نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ, and Allah had picked you to be the most chaste woman among all the women till the day of judgment. So you are the leader of all chaste women. Right? So here Allah is defending the honor of Maryam alayhi salam. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya Maryam, uqnuti li rabbik wasjudi warka'i ma'ar raki'in. Oh Maryam, Allah is appreciating her ruku and sajda, meaning his acts of ibadat. Allah is appreciating her. So like, Ya uqnuti li rabbik, increase, keep on increasing your ruku and sajda to me. Keep on increasing this ibadat that you are doing. Now my dear brothers and sisters, after mentioning the high sifat of Maryam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ذَلِكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْغَيْبِ نُوحِيهِ إِلَيْكَ. Allah said, these stories that I am telling you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whether it is Maryam, and just before that Allah mentioned the story of Zakariya and Yahya alayhi salatu wa sallam, right? Allah said, all these stories, right? Allah said, مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْغَيْبِ, for you, for Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these are the stories of ghayb. Ghayb means unseen, unheard of. Rasulullah had never heard about these stories, have never read about it because he could not read. And then another, مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَلْ كِتَاب وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ. In another prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I am giving this book, and before this you did not know what is kitab and what is iman, but I gave you this. So my dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, wa tafsila kulli shay. One of the biggest proof that our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the Rasul of Allah is Quran. And in Quran, the stories of Anbiya alayhi wa salatu wa salam, all of them are defending Prophet alayhi wa salatu wa salam. Now, but brothers, think about it. Think about one point. Is there any story in Quran regarding any Prophet of Allah? And there are nearly 33 or 32 prophets mentioned by name in Quran, right? 25? Okay, 25 mentioned in Quran. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Quran gave any insulting, defaming ayah regarding any prophet? Think about it. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he is narrating the stories, did Allah insult any prophet? No. Or did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about any prophet that he was, al-ayadh billah, a bad person, al-ayadh billah? No. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in Quran that Quran is defending the honor of Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Because when you look into other books, right? You are a Christian before that, right? This brother knows what I'm saying. That's why he's nodding his head. Because when you look into Bible and Torah, you find so much garbage about Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Right? Whether it's Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ishaq alayhi salatu wasalam, right? And others. So much garbage out there. So we brothers, Muslims, are the defenders of the honor of Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, of prophets. Right? That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, لِقَوْمِ يُؤْمِنُونَ, that you should believe in all those prophets to be innocents. Right? Innocents. I give you one example quickly. Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. Right? Now that dua that he made in the stomach of the whale, La ilaha illa anta subhanak, inni kuntu minaz zalimeen. That, Ya Allah, there is no God but you. Subhanak, you are exalted. Inni kuntu minaz zalimeen. I was among the wrongdoers. So the word zalimeen is used by every prophet for himself. Right? For himself. This is out of humility to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah, I am the one who is the sinner, who is the wrongdoer. Right? Like, Rabbana zalamna anfusana. Same thing, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have wronged ourselves. Meaning we have committed sins. So when Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam made that dua, what did Allah said? Fastajabna lahu. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمِّ وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That I instantly accepted the dua of Yunus. Right? First, and I I helped him by freeing him from that imprisonment that he found himself in the stomach of that whale. That whale delivered him outside. And Allah said, وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah said, in the same way, I will keep on helping mu'mineen. Now, my dear brothers, if you look into Bible, right on, they accuse Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam of wrongdoing. Right? As if Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam was a big criminal. Why did he leave his community without the permission from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Oh, he was a wrongdoer. He was a sinner. Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. Right? The only thing that Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam did was that when he saw on the horizon that the clouds are assembling and they are really dark clouds, it's thundering and lightning, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had already informed Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam that in 3 days, thalathat ayyam, right, in 3 days my punishment is going to come upon these people who are doing shirk, in 3 days. So Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam conveyed this message to the people that the punishment of Allah is coming, and he saw on the horizon the signs of Allah's punishment coming. He took his family and left. Right? Now every prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, whether it's about Rasulullah, what they do is that on a certain matter when no wahi had come, right? So they do ijtihad. They think, what should I do? What would be the best thing for me to do? Right? For example, I give you an example of Rasulullah, right? After the battle of Badr, the prisoners came. No wahi had come. First time, first battle. No hukum of Allah has come yet regarding what does Islam says about prisoners of war. Now Rasulullah is waiting for the wahi to come, but Allah's hikmah and wisdom, Allah did not send any wahi. Now Rasulullah made mashwara with Abu Bakr, Umar, and other sahaba, bhai, what should we do? What should we do? So Abu Bakr Siddiq said one thing, Umar was completely different, some other sahaba said. Now if there was a wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there was no need for Rasulullah to take any mashwara, to take any opinion. So Rasulullah, after listening to everybody's mashwara and opinion, like Allah said in Quran, فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. After listening to the opinion of the people, now you decide what should be the best course of action. So Rasulullah decided one thing. Right? Now what happened? When Rasulullah decided on that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed ayat in Quran in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not like the decision that Rasul made. But Allah did not blame Rasul for that decision because there was no wahi yet. So Rasul decided what he thought to be the best decision. But Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after deciding this, when Jibreel came, you know that ayah, what is that? What is that? The ayah that came after this? Al-ana khafafa Allahu anikum wa alima anna fikum dha'afa fa'in yakum minkum mi'atun sahabatun wallahu ma kana linabiyin an yakuna lahu asra حتى يثخر في الأرض تريدون عرض الدنيا والله يريد الآخرة والله عزيز حكيم. Then Allah said, لولا كتاب من الله سبق لمسكم فيما أفضتم فيه عذاب عظيم. But then after that Allah said, فكل Allah could not be blamed for that, because a human being, right, you can exert your best to come to the right conclusion. Yes, if there was a wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then definitely Rasulullah would not have asked mashwara, right? Same way, my dear brothers and sisters, with Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, that there was no wahi when he should leave the community, Right? Because prophets don't leave, they do not do hijrat without the permission from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? No prophet. That's why you know Rasulullah told Abu Bakr, right, to have the camel ready. So Abu Bakr used to say, Ya Rasulullah, when we are going to do the hijrat to Madinah Munawwara? Rasulullah said, have a guide ready and have a camel for you ready and for me ready. But Abu Bakr would say, Ya Rasulullah, when are we going to start the journey? Rasulullah, no, we have to wait till the wahi comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah's permission comes, and then we will leave. So many days passed by, and Abu Bakr Siddiq will keep on telling the guide. Now the guide was not Muslim. And Abu Bakr Siddiq had hired him and had made an agreement with him that you will not disclose this secret to anyone. So Arabs at that time, brothers, would never lie. One of the great qualities of even pre-Islamic time was the Arabs will not lie. Lying was like a big crime to them. So he did not lie. He did not disclose. And one night, our Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam comes, knocks the door of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, and he said that, Abu Bakr, we have to start the journey right now. Why? Because Jibreel just now came and he told me that Allah have ordered me that I should proceed to Madinah Munawwara. So at that time, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu said, Ya Rasulullah, Allah told you, so as-suhba, Ya Rasulullah, can I accompany you? Is it okay for me to accompany you? So Rasulullah said, yes, you will accompany me. And that's why when they were in the cave, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, thaniyathnain, you see? Thaniyathnain, idhuma fil ghar, idh yaqulu li sahibihi la tahzana. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Rasulullah and the second person, meaning Abu Bakr Siddiq. So Allah not only ordered Rasulullah to take Abu Bakr Siddiq with him, but Allah mentioned his companionship in Quran. So in the same way, my dear brothers, Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, he saw the signs of adab on the horizon. And he was waiting and waiting and waiting for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's order to come. So just like Rasulullah made a decision after Mashwara, after the battle of Badr, in the same way Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam thought, and he must have taken some mashwara from his people, and then he said, okay, let's leave the community. Allah did not like it, right? Allah did not like it, and then we all know what happened after that. He boarded a ship, a boat, and the people said that, you know, somebody who had run away from his master is riding the boat. So they will draw a lot. Who is that person? Each time they will draw a lot, Yunus alayhi salam's name will come. So they threw Yunus alayhi salam in the ocean. And then that whale swallowed him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not blame Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam for this. I'm telling you this story because in Bible you have all these very insulting stories regarding Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. Right? And if you look into the 17th juz of Quran, Surah Al-Anbiya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala very lovingly narrated the story of Yunus alayhi salatu. Allah said, Wadhannun idh dhahaba mughadiban fadhanna an lan naqdira alayh fanada fi adh-dhulumati an la ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu minadh-dhalimin. So this is out of love and affection towards Dhannun, Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. In other words, my dear brothers and sisters, in the entire Quran, so many prophets have been mentioned and their stories. But all Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching you and me, the followers of Quran, to believe in these prophets and respect them. And respect them. And learn lessons from their stories. Right? Very important, my dear brothers and sisters, to learn lessons from the stories. Ironically, my dear brothers and sisters, many times I see older people, you know, who have lived their lives in the world, and they know little or sometimes nothing about the stories of Quran. You know, it sometimes it breaks the heart that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have narrated so many stories. You are a Muslim. How come you never learned these stories about Quran? And if you not learn the stories from Quran, then Allah is saying ulul albab, then you are not an intelligent person. You are not an intelligent person. Brothers and sisters, yesterday or day before yesterday in India, the biggest seminary in India, right? That had maybe the most prestigious in the world, Deoband, it is called Deoband. Due to this coronavirus, their Sheikh al-Hadith Sahab, who was around 80 years old, he passed away, rahimahullah, 2 days ago. Now, I was reading briefly about him. I never met him. I never read any of his writings, to be honest. But when he died, rahimahullah, and on the Facebook, somebody posted his life, a brief sketch, and his contribution for all these years, right, teaching students of it. And I was thinking that such a great man lived amongst us and passed away, right? And we did not know about him, right? And he had taught, I don't know, since 60 years, how many students who became shuyukh, and then they taught so many students who became shuyukh, right, and so on and so forth. I said, look what a wealth of knowledge he had, right? But then I think that this person was such a knowledgeable person. But when you look into the masses, common Muslims, it seems like there's a big gap between the shuyukh and the common people. These shuyukh are like wealth of knowledge. And when you ask an ordinary Muslim about, for example, Yunus alayhi salam story, I'm telling you, you'll be surprised and say, I do not know Yunus. Yeah, I heard it's in Quran, but what about his story? Right? Yusuf alayhi salatu was salam. No, I mean, even the Siyatul Nabi, I mean, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is your Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But how much do you know about him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? So brother, this is a big gap. And Allah is saying that if you do not know the stories of these prophets alayhi salatu wa sallam, so you will not be able to learn lessons from the stories. So you are not ulul albab. Then you are not intelligent person. And brother, I would like to end this talk with one point. Think about it, brothers. And because of coronavirus, all these kind of depressing thoughts are coming because so many people are dying. I'm from India, so so many relatives have passed away in the last 3 days. I often think, my dear sisters, there was one of my relatives, let me tell you this, one of my cousin, first cousin, he was right at the brink of building a huge plaza, shopping plaza, in Lucknow. Right? For that, he had worked for 10, 12 years, buying the land, getting the finances, getting the plan approved, right, and everything. And he was right there. Maybe I think in a month or two, I guess, he was going to start building the shopping plaza. He died in 2 days or 3 days. He got coronavirus. And 36 hours before his death, I was talking to him. He was healthy. He had some problem, but he was in 36 hours, he was dead. When he died, since he was my cousin, I was thinking about his plan of building a shopping plaza. Right? And I was thinking that my brother, my cousin was going to build this. Now he is in his grave. All that wealth, that property is still there, abandoned. It's still there. I don't know what his son is going to do. But my dear, I was thinking that nothing will go with you. But if you have knowledge about Quran, right? Quran will be your what? Rasulullah said, Jalis. Rasulullah, he will be your Jalis in Qabr. Quran will be your companion in Qabr. Subhanallah. Rasulullah said, if you love Quran, study Quran, Quran would be your companion in Qabr. So my dear brothers and sisters, think about it. How much you know about Quran? Ramadan just finished, month of Quran, right? That's why, brothers and sisters, this coming month now, let's take Quran seriously. Wallahi, brothers, you will make the best decision of your life if you will decide to take Quran seriously. Recite Quran, but understand. Learn the stories of Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. You know, and you will get so many lessons of life from these stories of Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help you, may understand. Subhanallah bihamdi, subhanakallahu bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.